Hi and hola para amigos. Clinical reasoning is an essential skill for medical education. Without it, the optimal patient care cannot be delivered. Lack of it is a threat to the patient's safety and also increases healthcare costs. If it is so important, how is it taught in medical schools all around the world? What are the main strategies to teach clinical reasoning? To answer these questions, researchers took advantage of the most prominent medical education conference, AMI conference. The researchers sent a survey form for the participants of the conference in 2018. They have collected 313 responses from 76 countries. They took a snapshot of the world on teaching clinical reasoning. These pretty flamingos are excited to delve into the results. But first, the intro. The researchers asked, how is and should clinical reasoning be taught in your curriculum in sessions with a main focus on clinical reasoning? Nearly half of the participants were from Europe, North and South America. Here are the results. Bedside teaching is the most preferred strategy with 76%. The second strategy is problem-based learning with 62%. Lectures are at the third place and it's 53%. Clerkships and morning rounds are following it. Virtual patients, so-called interactive online cases, is close to them. These was the rates on how is taught. They also asked how should be, and here are the results. It seems that lectures constitute far higher than it should be. We should implement what we know. We need to get rid of lecture dominance. It's not an adequate way to teach clinical reasoning. The most salient result is that the highest difference between how is and should is at interactive online cases. Many participants think that presence of interactive online cases should be more. At this point, I must mention our recent work on interactive online cases. I recommend you to check that paper to explore a useful way to implement interactive online cases. I dropped the link at the description below. Take a look at context-ended questions. Anyway, let's get back to the current article. The researchers asked another question. What, in your opinion, are the main barriers, challenges for introducing a clinical reasoning curriculum? Here are the results. We could conclude that, first and foremost, awareness should be raised. The second barrier is lack of guidelines for clinical reasoning curriculum development. All in all, conclusion of this article expressed the gist of the current situation. Global respondents indicate the need to implement explicit longitudinal clinical reasoning curricula. Our findings suggest that efforts should be put into improving faculty development, including evidence-based materials on how to teach and assess clinical reasoning. I left the link of the article at the description below. See you and adios para amigos. And also, don't forget these pretty flamingos and consider to subscribe if you liked.